हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ साइंस क्लास 4। टुडे वी विल अंडरस्टैंड लेसन 14 एंड विल सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज ऑफ लेसन 14 कीपिंग अ अर्थ ग्रीन। यू मे हैव हर्ड द अर्थ कॉल्ड द ब्लू मार्बल, बट डू यू नो व्हाई द वर्ल्ड इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ग्रीन अर्थ? So, in the most obvious sense, the world is green because it is covered by plants. But why are plants green? So, plants are green because they have chlorophyll in their leaves, which they use to absorb sunlight and create their own energy. Then do you know why is earth considered as the home of human being and other organism? So earth is the only planet with favorable living condition which form our environment, and the availability of a large amount of water has made it possible for all living beings to survive easily on earth. And as earth is the large habitat for all living beings, and as earth provide air, water, food, shelter, etc. to the living beings, we can say that earth is home to different kinds of plant and animals. Now, do you know if you cut down a tree, what you should do? Yes, you should plant two new ones, because trees are very useful and important. And the most important is, trees are necessary for rain. They create cold and humid atmosphere required for rain. And second, when it rains, tree holds the water and doesn't allow to pass over soil, which avoid floods. And third, they provide food to all of living. But if we continue to cut tree at large extent, then it will definitely affect the rainfall and also create unstable atmosphere, which will lead to destruction of earth. And even when we cut down trees, we are taking a home away from animals, and we lose the ground, which will mostly cause landslides. And as trees cause shade, without that shade, the ground will dry up faster and there will not as much nutrition as previous. So we can say that as we are cutting down trees without planting enough of them, the earth is no longer as green and beautiful as it used to be. Now, do you know why trees are very important for us? So, trees are very important as they are very useful. Like, trees help us to stay healthy. They remove 53 tons of carbon dioxide and 430 pounds of air pollutants annually. And according to the US Department of Agriculture, USDA, trees keep us cool, and trees can cut air conditioning cost by 56% and give us food from apples to oranges. So fruiting trees feed us, means provide fruits, and even trees stop erosion. Their root system slows and stop rain runoff by absorbing excess water, and this reduces the amount of soil that is washed into streams and lakes and decrease erosion. And even trees benefit health. Over 20 species of trees and shrubs are known to have medicinal properties. Even trees benefit the environment. They absorb carbon dioxide. As they grow and the carbon that they store in their wood helps slow the rate of global warming. Even they reduce wind speed and cool the air as they lose moisture and reflect heat upwards from their leaves. And it is estimated that trees can reduce the temperature in a city by up to 7 degrees Celsius. Trees also help prevent flooding and soil erosion. Even trees keep the atmosphere cool. Because trees are living things, they respire and therefore they keep the air humid, and as they constantly exchange gases and water, which eventually result in the cooling effect experienced on Earth. Even the United States Department of Agriculture, USDA, notes that about 56% of air conditioning cost is covered by the coolant effect of trees. Even trees provide wood for building. Since shelter is a basic necessity of every man, trees play a major role in helping men to establish an appropriate shelter for themselves, and in fact they are used as a basic structure in roofing and casting processes during the construction of building or houses. And selected species of trees particularly used for this purpose are obtained from the forest after appropriate licenses have been secured. So trees provide wood for building. Even they provide shelter for insects, birds and other animals. Many insects, birds, lizards as well as other animals live entirely in the tree. Like for example, an animal which breeds a nest in trees are birds. And other animals include squirrels, mice, beetles and ants. Even trees stop erosion. The root of various trees reduce erosion by holding onto the soil particles, and also during rainfall they cause water to flow down their trunk rather than just running off the soil surface. And therefore they reduce the amount of soil that runs off with water and preserve soil integrity. Even trees keep the atmosphere cool because trees are living thing, they respire. And therefore they keep the air humid as they constantly exchange gases and water, which eventually result in the cooling effect experience on Earth. Even United States Department of Agriculture notes that about 56% of air conditioning cost is covered by coolant effect of trees. Even trees release oxygen, which is needed by all living beings, and they are very friendly to our environment. They reduce the impact of various harmful chemicals released on Earth, and excess CO2 means carbon dioxide is also absorbed by the leaves of trees as they respire, and while they give off oxygen, which is very essential for man's respiration. Now, do you know what is deforestation? So, it can be defined as the large-scale removal of trees from forest or other lands for facilitation of human activities. And it is a serious environmental concern since it can result in loss of biodiversity, damage to natural habitat, disturbance in the water cycle and soil erosion. And it is also a contributor to climate change and global warming. So So, as trees are very important, we can save trees and keep our earth green by following different steps like planting trees in large number, which is called afforestation, which is the establishment of a forest or a stand of trees in an area where there was no previous tree cover. And sometimes special tools such as a tree planting bar are used to make a planting of trees easier and faster. We are all aware that we can help save trees from being cut down by using less paper. But how can our children help? So make a scrap paper drawer to reuse paper. Make a space in your home for paper that's blank on one side and then reuse it before you recycle it, and encourage your children to do this every time they create their art, and use scrap paper for coloring and drawing, and use handkerchief and cloth napkins instead of tissue paper. And choose a reusable lunch box for school and nursery. Instead of paper or plastic bag, complete with reusable container, metal utensil, a cloth napkin, and reusable water bottle. Even planting trees is a great and fun activity for children. And the best time to do this is autumn. Even do your research to make sure you pick the right tree for your space, as some trees have complex root system that can damage buildings or may grow too high and limit light. And even the best way for children to feel connected to trees and forest is to spend time with them. So visit a local or national park and get to your smell and see the amazing sight of the forest habitat. Even in India, Van Mahotsav is celebrated for a week in the month of July every year, and lakhs of trees are planted all over the country during these 7 days. And even the United Nations also observes a day called the World Environment Day. And on this day, people talk about ways to save the environment. And we celebrate World Environment Day on 5th June. Do you know what is wildlife and wild animal? So, a wild animal is non-domestic and lives their entire life in natural habitat. And a few examples of wild animals are tigers, lions, elephant, and giraffe. And wild animals keep on moving from one place to another. So, we can say that animals that live in the wild forest are a part of wildlife, and different wild animals are important to the environment in different ways. Like, they are a part of food chain. The term food chain describes the order in which organisms or living things depend on each other for food, and every community of living thing has one or more food chain. And most food chains start with organisms that make their own food, such as plants. So we can say that all animals depend on plants and on each other for food. And this connection between them for food forms the food chain in the environment. And the loss of any animal or plant from this food chain will lead to another animal dying and causing an imbalance to nature. Even they help to scatter seeds. As you know that food is one of the basic necessity of all living beings and it stands first among all basic needs. Even animal need food to survive. And as you know that animals such as a squirrel, monkey and even certain birds eat the fruit and seeds of some plants. And sometimes they throw away the seeds to far off places. Even at other hand, they eat the seed and which are later removed through their feces or droppings. And in this way, these animals help to scatter seeds. Now, do you know why are wild animals in danger? So, as a population and needs grow, we are leaving less and less room for wildlife. And so this wildlife is under threat from many different kind of human activities, from directly destroying habitat or other. And that's why they are facing multiple threats. So we can say that wild animals are in great danger of becoming extinct from the face of the earth, mainly due to reckless human activities such as mining, destruction of forest for creating cities and towns, and hunting and killing of animals. And as earth is the large habitat for all living beings, and as earth provides air, water, food, shelter, etc. to the living beings, they are natural homes of many animals such as monkey, squirrel, birds, sloth, as well as insect. And we should therefore save trees by preventing their reckless cutting down. And we should also avoid clearing away of forested area. And as wildlife is under threat from many different kind of human activities, hunting and killing of animals for their body parts should be banned. And we should also avoid using things made from animal parts such as fur, skin means leather, and tusk. This will discourage the hunting of wild animal. Now let's solve question 3. Give one word for the following. First, P-A-R-T, part O-F of T-H-E, the P-L-A-N-T, plant, T-H-A-T, that H-O-L-D-S, holds, T-H-E, the S-O-I-L, soil, I-N, in, P-L-A-C-E, place. So the question is part of the plant that holds the soil in place. Answer, R-O-O-T-S, roots, means a part of the plant that holds the soil in a place is root. Now next question, C-U-T-T-I-N-G, cutting, D-O-W, and down, T-R-E-E-S, trees, I-N-N, L-A-R-G-E, large, N-U-M-B-E-R-S, numbers. So the question is cutting down trees in large number. Answer, D-E-F-O-R-E-S-T-A-T-R-O-N, deforestation, means cutting down trees in large number is called deforestation. Now next question, P-L-A-N-T-I-N-G, planting, T-R-E-E-S, trees, I-N-N, L-A-R-G-E, large, N-U-M-B-E-R-S, numbers. So the question is planting trees in large numbers. Answer AFFORESTATION, afforestation means planting trees in large number is called afforestation. Now let's solve question 4. Answer the following question. First, HOW how, DO do, TREES trees, HELP help, IN LOWERING lowering, TSE the, TEMPERATURE temperature, OF off, APLACE place. How do trees help in lowering the temperature of place? Answer TREES trees, RELEASE release, WATER water, VAPOUR vapor, WHICH which, HELPS helps, IN LOWERING lowering, THE the, TEMPERATURE temperature, OF off, APLACE place. So answer trees release water vapor which helps in lowering the temperature of a place. Now next question, WHY SHOULD should, WEVNOT nod, WASTE waste, PAPER paper. So the question is why should we not waste paper? Answer WEVSHOULD should, NOT not, WASTE waste, PAPER paper, BECAUSE because, ALOT lot, OF off, TREES trees, ARER CUT cut, DOW and down, TO2 MAKE make, PAPER paper. So answer is we should not waste paper because a lot of trees are cut down to make a paper. Now next question, WHAT what, IS is, DEFORESTATION deforestation. Answer CUTTING cutting, DOW and down, TREES trees, INN LARGE large, NUMBERS numbers, IS is, CALLED call, DEFORESTATION deforestation. So answer is cutting down trees in large numbers is called deforestation. Now next question, HOW how, DO do, PLANTS plant, AND and, ANIMALS animals, DEPEND depend, O and on, EACH is, OTHER other. So the question is how do plants and animals depend on each other? Answer PLANTS plants, AND and, ANIMALS animals, depend, depend o and on, each is, other, other, for, food. So answer is plants and animals depend on each other for food. Now next question, mention, mention, twos, ways, I n in, which, wecan, can, save, wildlife, wildlife. Mention two ways in which we can save wildlife. Answer, first, prevent, prevent, recklessness, reckless, cutting, cutting, down, off, trees. So first way is prevent reckless cutting down of trees. Now second way, hunting, hunting, and killing, killing, of animals, animals, for, their, body, body, parts, parts, should, bend, bend. So second way, hunting and killing of animals for their body part should be bent. Now next question, when, is, the, world, environment, environment, day, day. Answer, the, world, environment, environment, day, day. Is, celebrated, celebrated, on, 5th, June, June. So answer, the World Environment Day is celebrated on 5th June. So today we have learned about importance of trees, that trees are important to us because they are useful in many ways, like the roots of trees hold the soil, they release water vapor into atmosphere and cooling the surrounding, they release oxygen which is needed by all living beings. Then we have learned about how to save trees, like we can save trees by planting more trees than we cut down, and even by not wasting paper but try to reuse it as much as possible, because a lot of trees are cut down to make paper. Then we have learned about importance of wildlife, that all animals depend on plants and on each other for food, which forms food chain, and the loss of any animal or plant from this food chain will lead to another animal dying or causing an imbalance. Then we have learned about how to save wildlife, like we can save wildlife by saving trees by preventing their reckless cutting down, and we should also avoid clearing away of forested area. Even we can save wildlife by banning hunting and killing of animals for their body parts. And even we should also avoid using things made from animals' parts such as fur, skin, leather and tusk. And this will discourage the hunting of wild animals.